Good morning, students. In today's class of retail management, we'll start a new topic, that is the Indian retail sectors structures. In the previous class, we have studied about what are the various retailing concepts and how they help to shape the retail strategy of the organization. All the four retailing concepts, that is being customer oriented, being coordinated, having coordinated efforts, being goal oriented, and value driven. If retail sector tries, retail outlet tries to be do all these four things, that is being goal oriented, value driven, make coordinated efforts, and being customer oriented, then these four main points will help to shape the retailing concept, and this retailing concept will help to give shape to the retail strategy of the retail outlet or retail organization. So this we have read in the previous class. In today's class, we are focusing on the what are the various major retail sector structures. Okay, there are basically two kind of structures: organized and unorganized. So we'll be understanding each of them. So let us understand, before going into the structures, let us understand what is the scope of retail industry in India. Okay, so a little bit of introduction. Retail, Indian retail accounts to over 10% of country's GDP. So it is one of the sectors which contributes to the GDP of the country, and it is for this reason that Indian retail occupies such importance, such vitality, because a major portion of country's GDP is coming from this Indian retail sector. Okay, now coming to the second part, Indian retail provides around 8% of the employment. Of all the employment that is available in India, around 8% of employment is being provided by the Indian retail sector. It may be directly in the Indian retail sector, or otherwise all the associated sectors which are linked with the Indian retail sectors. All these things together, the whole Indian retail sector provides around 8% of the total employment in the country. India is the world's fifth largest global destination in the retail space. Not only this, India has a major position, that is fifth in the world or the global destination for retail space. Indian retail industry has reached 950 billion in 2018 and expected to reach US$1.2 trillion by 2021. So these are the figures. What is the total size of the retail industry? It is 950 billion. It was 950 billion in 2018, and is expected to reach US$1.2 trillion by 2021. So we can see that there is a tremendous scope of growth in the Indian retail sector. India was ranked the first in the Global Retail Development Index in 2017. Back in 2017, India was ranked the first in the Global Retail Development Index. This shows that there is a growth in retail development in India is maximum, will be maximum. Overall, retail market is expected to grow at 12% per annum. Not only this, the market is expected to grow at a rate of 12% per annum. So this is a very good growth rate, and this is boosting or fueling the increase in the size of the retail sector in India. The Indian retail industry is one of the most dynamic and fast-paced industries, with several players entering into the market. Previously, only Indian retail giants were present, but due to foreign direct investment, foreign players are entering to the Indian market, and the new schemes like Make in India are making it, pushing or fueling this concept, and new FDI is coming into India and people are interested to enter India in a big way. So this is boosting the retail industry in India. Now, we'll give you some infographic images which will show the size of the retail industry. As you can see in the above diagram, the market size, this shows the market size of the for the first few years. Okay, so in 2014 it was 534 billion. So there has been steady growth from 534 billion to 2015 it became 600 billion, then 641 billion in 2016. It rose to 672 billion in 2017. As we have understood previously, it was 950 billion in 2018. By 2021, it is expected to be 1.2 trillion, and by 2026 future estimated, it will be 1750 or 1.75 trillion. This is the expected growth rate of the market size that will grow in India. And sector-wise, if we try to break up as per the financial 19, we can see that the apparel and footwear, the consumer durables and IT, information technology, jewelries and accessories, health and entertainment, home decor, beauty, others, each and every sector, you can see that there has been a continuous growth in the various sectors. So these sectors are the major sectors which lead to the growth of the Indian retail sector. Now, coming to the major key trends, not only offline, the online retail industry is growing by leaps and bounds. In 2017, it was 17.8 billion. In 2020, this it is expected to be 60 billion, and by 2022, it is expected to be $73 billion. The Indian e-commerce market, you can see there has been a great growth. Both the e-commerce and the online market has been a great one, because people are now moving towards online platforms to buy more goods and services. And given the situations the prevailing in India as for the COVID-19, there is a major reason, one of the major reasons which will also boost the growth of the online or the e-commerce industry in India. And if you look at the what are the government initiatives the government has done, it has relaxed the investment rules for supermarkets and retail industry. So for foreign direct investment, it is allowing nearly 100% single brand retail, or 100% for single brand retail you can get foreign direct investment, and for multi-brand it is 51%. So the government is also making ways for the foreign retail industries to come into India and grow in India. So the foreign direct investment, to attract foreign direct investment, the government has made, this is 51% FDI is approved in multi-brand and 100% is approved in single brand retail. Now coming to the, when we say that we are, we, today's class will read about the retail sectors, retail sector structures, right? And I told you there are two major sector structures in the Indian retail sector, that is unorganized sector and the organized sector. As per the BCG and KPMG research was done, and also Deloitte was part of it, and the report was made. Okay, and from that it was found that in 2015 the unorganized sector was 92% and the organized sector was 8%, and by 2020 it was expected to be 76% of the unorganized sector and 24% for the organized sector. So this was the expectation for 2020. Okay, so now we'll start to understand the two major structures which we have highlighted here, that is unorganized sector and the organized sector. Now moving to the first thing, that is unorganized retailing. What do we mean by unorganized retailing, and what are the various kind of formats that are included in the unorganized retailing. We will be dealing with this. Okay, so we will understand what is unorganized retailing. Unorganized retailing refers to the original platform of low cost retailing in India. Unorganized retailing refers to the various neighborhood punch shop, kirana shops, which was prevalent in India since the beginning of retail. And this is known as the unorganized sector. It refers to the original platforms of low cost retailing. Neighborhood kirana shops, owner-manned general stores, small pan beauty outlets, convenience stores, side cart and pavement suppliers, etc. are examples of unorganized retailing in India. So these are the major players who constitute nearly 76 to 80% of the market. Okay, and they constitute the neighborhood kirana stores, that is your local baniya shops, owner man general stores, small stores where this is completely controlled by the owner or is the family members of the owner. Okay, these are also known as single outlet shops. Okay, yeah, single chain, there is no chain, only single outlet shops. The small pan and bidi outlets you must have been witnessing in India. The various small convenience store where you can get food, grocery and other items. And also the side cart and pavement suppliers. Those who use the side cart for delivering like these products, they come to your doorstep. The side cart and these pavement suppliers, this chart and other small eateries that are made on these small carts, pavement suppliers, all are included in the unorganized retailing. According to the latest joint report by Deloitte and Retail Association of India, the share of traditional retail trade or the unorganized retail trade will decline from 75% in 2021 to 75% in 2021 from 88% in 2017. So, 88% in 2017, it was 88% the size of the organized retailing in India, and this is going to decline by decline to 75% in 2021. Why the unorganized sector is declining? Because the organized sector is increasing its place, increasing its size. And in India, even though both unorganized and organized sector are available or prevalent, the growth of the organized sector will help to the growth of the retail sector, and it will give more employment, and the retail sector will be able to contribute more to the GDP. So we are interested in strengthening the organized retail in India. So it was a joint report by Deloitte and Retail Association of India. And one of the major things you can see in organized retailing and unorganized retailing is that characterized by small retailers and are subject to tax evasion and lack of labor law system. So these are the three things which are our main points or characteristics of the unorganized retailing. Because they are small retailer, they are subject to tax evasion. Why? Because they don't pay their taxes. They try to evade these taxes. Evasion of taxes is there. And also they are very small retailers. They don't have no bargaining power with the suppliers. And they have lack of labor law system. They are generally manned by the people, by the owner or the people in the family. So even though if they appoint one or two small or a small child or a person to assist them, they are not governed by the official labor law system. So these are the main characteristics of the unorganized retailing in India. And finally, these are not registered with the government and the terms of employment are not regular and fixed. So this is also one of the characteristics, because these are not registered by the government. If they were registered, they would have become organized retailing, part of organized retailing. Since they are not registered, they are part of the unorganized retailing in India. And also the terms of employment are not regular and fixed. There is a lack of labor law system, even the terms of employment are not fixed and they don't get regular salaries. So we can in a gist we can explain that the organized retailing sector dominates the total retailing activity in India. Okay, and it includes thousands of small retail shops spread over the entire geographical area of the country. Okay, it refers to the traditional format of retail industries, and these sectors consist of the major local shops, local kirana shops, paan bidi shops. These things are major formats or major types of unorganized retailing that is available in India. But with the growth of this foreign direct investment, as we have studied that the foreign direct government is making ways of increasing the foreign direct investment in India, and due to this increase in the foreign direct investment, it is expected to shrink, this or unorganized retailing is expected to shrink, and this because there will be expansion of the organized retail in India. One of the major things you have to also understand, because this sector is not at a register. Okay, no government rules, regulations or implications are followed in the unorganized sector. Okay, so and they don't pay any kind of taxes, they don't follow any kind of labor laws. So these things are not minimum wages act, none of these rules, regulations are followed by the unorganized sector. It is one of the, these are the major things, problem with the unorganized retailing. That is the reason we want that the size of the unorganized retailing should shrink. And there are certain advantages of unorganized retailing also, like it are easy to establish and there is no need for registration or affiliation for entering into the sector. So these are the two main advantages why people are more interested of being a part of the unorganized retailing, because these are require less capital and they are not registered, they don't require any kind of affiliations, any kind of certifications to open the unorganized retail form shops, and also these are very easy to install or establish. Similarly, there are no taxes levied because they don't show the total sales and other things, so they are not part of the taxation system. They try to evade the or do tax evasion. So this is the major understanding of the organized retailing in India. So once we have understood what are the major things, organized retailing, what are the various types of unorganized retailing, we should now also understand what are the various challenges that are faced by the unorganized retailing. The thing is that even though these are easy to set up, they require less capital, they don't require any kind of affiliations, there is no taxes, there are certain challenges with the which the unorganized retailing faces, which the organized retail does not face. Okay, we'll understand about those challenges. Okay, so what are the various challenges which are faced by the Indian unorganized retail sector? First one is lack of best practice in inventory management and supply chain management. The best practices of the sector cannot be followed by the unorganized retail sector. Why? Because the unorganized retail sector do not have a lot of capital to invest in various inventory management and supply chain management, and they cannot use technology because they don't have that much skill and that much capital or time to invest in these things. Inventory management is very difficult because they keep very minimum inventory with them because they don't want that they should be overstocking their shops, or there must be any stocks that are left which are not unsold. And even the supply chain management also, they cannot focus on a very lean supply chain management because here the suppliers have an advantage over the small unorganized retailers, because the unorganized retailers do not have a very good bargaining power. They are not able to bargain good rates with the supplier. Even the supply time and the consistent delivery by the suppliers, they are not done, and the unorganized retailers face a lot of problems. Okay, so these are the major, one of the major challenges. because there is a lack of best practice in both inventory management and supply chain management. Next, there is lack of standardization. We don't have any standard format for the unorganized retailers. The same when we say in organized retail, we say a particular store. If we say it's a supermarket, or if you say it's a hypermarket, so there are very standardized formats. Whenever you will see that there is a supermarket in whatever place in India or outside India also, they have very standard format of operating. But in unorganized retail sector, it is seen that there is no standardization at all. Anybody and anyone, anybody can open any kind of unorganized retail outlet, and there is no set rules for that. What are the kind of commodities or merchandise that will be given, how the merchandise will be given, what are the various facilities that will be made available to the consumers. All these things are not completely understood, are not standardized in the unorganized retail sector. So this is one of the also differentiating factor between organized retail and unorganized retail in India. Then come to next point. There is stiff competition from organized retail sector. There is unorganized retailers face a very stiff competition from organized retail sector, both online and offline organized retail sector. Why? Because people today are more concerned about the quality of the merchandise or the product. They are interested that they will get a proper after-sales services, warranties and guarantees. So, and they also want branded products. So they shift towards organized retail sector to buy their merchandise. And these unorganized retail sector do not have big brands with them, and the quality of the product is somewhat a little bit degraded or substandard. And so, because the prices are also less in organized retail sector merchandise. So this organized retail sector is giving a stiff competition, because in today's generation of young people, they are much more concerned, they're much more brand conscious, and they're much more concerned about the quality of the product. They're not concerned about the price. So, and they also want to flaunt a very branded products. So the organized retail sector is, the size of the organized retail sector is day by day increasing in India. So this unorganized retail sector is giving a very stiff competition to the unorganized retail sector. Now coming to the next point, lack of knowledge, skills and training. As I have said that we have discussed earlier also in this video, that this unorganized retailers are generally small shops, small mom and pop shops, small kirana stores, pan bedi stores, and also this convenience, small convenience stores or owner manned stores. So they don't undergo any kind of skills or training. They don't have any specialized idea of how to operate the retail outlet. They don't have any degrees. Even an uneducated person can open an unorganized retail sector. So all these things are, this knowledge, skills and training are not present in unorganized retail sector. Maybe some of the unorganized retailers may be educated, may be having some kind of knowledge about the retail outlet, but majority of the unorganized retail sector, the retailers, unorganized retailers do not have any formal training in retail management. That they have very few skills and negligible knowledge about how to operate the retail outlet. So this is one of the major challenges for the unorganized retail sector, because if they had the knowledge, skills and adequate knowledge, skills and training, they would have performed better and they would have been able to meet the organized retail sector competition in a much more proper way. But since there is a lack of knowledge, skills and training in the unorganized retail sector, so this forms as a challenge for the unorganized retail sector. Now come to the next point, consumers shifting towards the organized retail markets, because as we have discussed earlier also, the consumers are now much more brand conscious and quality conscious, and they want to shop from places, from retail outlets, from organized retail outlets, because they can flaunt the products. They can also want a very good ambience and atmospherics of the retail outlet, which is very good in organized retail sector. They don't want to buy products from small, dingy outlets, unorganized retail outlets, which sells generally unbranded or small brands of products, merchandise. So these customers or the consumers are shifting. Even though previously they were interested in buying products from or merchandise from this small organized retailers, nowadays they are shifting this towards this organized retail markets. Like if you say, for example, previously people were interested in buying this goods and commodities, especially their normal day-to-day fresh grocery and other dry groceries from small kirana shops or small mom and pop stores, but nowadays they are interested to go to bigger organized retail markets because the society is also changing. Previously people were having enough time to invest in this shopping, but nowadays these customers do not, or the consumers do not have enough time, and they are both the male and the female, both the persons are of the family are working, and since they both of them have very less time to concentrate on shopping matters, so they try to shop from a particular organized retail store where under one roof they can get all the products and services which they want to for their survival. So they are not interested in going to various small unorganized retailers, but rather go to a bigger established organized retail outlet where they can get under one roof all the products and services that they require. So culturally also, socially also, there has been a lot of changes. There has been a lot of education. People are through the various media, through the internet, through TV, satellite, through other means of newspaper and magazines, they are able to understand about the various brands, the the kind of impact it has on the social status of the persons. A person's having a small unbranded clothes purchased from an organized, unorganized retailer, and a person wearing very branded outfit from an organized retail sector. So we can understand that there has been a shift in the perception of the consumers, and they want to buy more from the organized retail markets. So this is posing, this is also posing as one of the major challenges for the unorganized retail sector. Okay, then coming to the next challenge, that is lack of government policies discouraging the unorganized retailers. Even the government policies are discouraging the unorganized retailers. Why? Because they are not more interested in making the unorganized retail. They want to reduce the size of the unorganized retail, because the unorganized retail, they don't follow any government rules, regulations. They are not paying any taxes. So they cannot be controlled by the government. So they don't know how this unorganized retail operates. So there is a lot of gray areas in this. So the government also wants that the size of the unorganized retail should shrink, even though not completely removed from the economy. They want that the size of the unorganized retail must shrink. And how they are discouraging, they are making these policies for foreign direct investment. As we have studied earlier, that there is 100% FDI is allowed in single brand retail and for multi-brand retail. It is 51%. So the government is making a lot of policies for encouraging foreign direct investment, which allows this major, huge retail giants from outside India like Walmart, Amazon entering into India, eBay and Alibaba entering into India. And this is one of, also considered as one of the major challenges for the unorganized retail sector, because the unorganized sector is facing stiff competition from the organized retail sector. And finally, another challenge for the unorganized sector is lack of capital. Even though these unorganized retail outlets can be opened very easily, established very easily with less capital, this lack of capital, even though it's a boon, it's a bane also, because they are not able to expand their operations because of lack of capital. They cannot have a lot of inventory and because of lack of capital. And since they have lack of capital, they are not able to have a good inventory. So they don't have a good bargaining power with the suppliers. Since they buy very small quantities of merchandise from the supplier, the suppliers also take advantage of it, and they don't give them any kind of benefit. The small unorganized retailers cannot take the advantage of economies of scale because they are buying in very small quantities. So they cannot take advantage of economies of scale or have good bargaining power against these suppliers, and the suppliers take advantage of it. So this lack of capital is also is one of the major reasons which is creating a challenge for the unorganized retail sector. So in today's class, we have understood what is the total retail sector in India, Indian retail sector, how it is, what is the size, and what is the growth pattern and growth in the future, the expected growth in the future. We have understood there are two kinds of sectors, that is unorganized retail sector and organized retail sector. We have also understood that the unorganized retail sector, what are the various types of retail outlets present in the unorganized retail sector, and what are the various challenges that are faced by the unorganized retail sector. Okay, I will be sending you the notes digitally. Please go through that. Thank you for your attention. No need to panic. Stay at home. Thank you.